Welcome to MTV Cribs.
Welcome to my crib.
We don't get to go in yet. So today is Wednesday. No, Tuesday. We are getting ready to fly out. Turns out, have to have surgery.
And we just got here.
It looked good. Yeah. I came back from California, and I got to go back to California to have surgery. So it looked good at first, and then the plate moved or some stuff happened. I don't know, but I have to have surgery.
So now we're flying out.
This vlog episode is going to be a house tour and the whole kind of going to surgery, doing all that stuff. So welcome to my crib. This is
guard dog.
He's a creature. He's a raccoon. If you look here, he's a raccoon. And I'm holding on to him because he likes to run outside. So come on, get back in. Come on. To the most important part of the house, of the actual house, right here. This is Caleb, my Oklahoma roommate's room. And this is just our guest bedroom.
We don't need to go in there.
This is the most important part of the house.
Really?
It's my gun closet.
Who organized it for you?
Riley. She had the idea of putting tubs in here. I got my night vision helmet in brown, black, headphones for shooting, gloves and glasses. This is a box of slings. This is a gas mask that I have that I haven't even opened it up. I actually need to open it up with how things are getting.
You can describe more of this when you do your shooting vlog.
This is a house tour. This is just miscellaneous gun parts, my plate carriers, and some holsters, and a bunch of stuff.
Nice.
So, living room right here.
We have this nice bike.
So yeah, I got bicycles in here because I'm going to have to do something whenever I get my collarbone fixed. Ron brought those. That's an arm bike, and that's just a normal bike. I won't be able to do the arm bike much for a while, but whenever I can. Game system, the newer Xbox, the OG Xbox.
All these wires drive me nuts.
Oh, there's the Xbox 360, a bunch of games, some movies. Yeah, Riley doesn't like the wire situation, but what are you gonna do? My big TV.
Do you have a comment on my pillows?
This couch is sick. The pillows, whatever. But this couch is actually sick. This wasn't the couch we were gonna get, but they canceled our order and we needed a couch because this was like the last thing we needed. It was like the main thing in the living room. And so we just went in and bought the first one we saw, basically.
Well,
the
it's
first
so comfy.
Like, deep couch we saw, and I'm glad we went back because we didn't see this one the first time. And this one's super deep, and it's really, we've had like everybody who comes to our house is like, that couch is so sick, and it wasn't even that expensive. So.
We have Moto Playground on our coffee table of baby Austin.
Oh, well, this is really my room. But
the office,
it's like we split the office. He actually uses like a full gaming setup. I need to get one. We even have a desk for whenever I get one.
We haven't finished this room.
And I need to get one too because I've been playing on a little screen in California and I came back to my big screen and it's kind of throwing me off. So I need to get it. But anyway, this is just kind of a little, I have a lot of trophies in the garage, but here's just a few kind of extras that I've never before in the garage.
Show the picture I got you.
Cool painting of this little kid with a crown machine gun. A bunch of pictures and stuff. That's sick.
He saw it online, so I blew it up and framed
it
for him.
Yeah, that's sick. I got a bunch of, the frame one. Yep, the frame one. The framed one. And here's another one with all the patches on it.
Jesse Burrows.
Yeah, this is a U.S. Army one with a bunch of patches and stuff. Same thing. Same guys, but I think this is the same guys. Yeah, like, it's got the airborne patches and stuff, so that's really cool.
Here's our roommate.
That's Caleb. That's all we need to talk about, Caleb.
You're mean to
Caleb. Here's our kitchen table, which is usually my gun table. Riley cleaned it off, and I just came back from the gun shop before we got to fly out, and I picked up all this stuff in the gun shop, so, like, ARC.
It's rarely cleared, Caleb?
You
can attest to that.
Some other gun parts. This is like a bolt action, like sniper-ish rifle, so it's she's got her all decoration and stuff over there. It's lovely. It's fantastic. I love it. This is what I'm most proud of in all the everything we bought other than the couch. This is what I'm most proud of. I was like being real cheap. Not real cheap. I guess we spent a lot on our bedroom set, but this fridge was expensive. But I think it's sick. I think it looks super sick. Without all the stuff in there, it looks better, but the like lighting from the back.
Without it actually being used.
Yeah. So that's why I saw it in the store and I was like, damn, that looks sick. It's probably why they do that.
But this is my kitchen. Oh, guys.
This has an autofill. This has autofill. You push it, put a cup down, no matter the size, and it fills it up right to the top, right, like, I don't know how it does that. Doesn't make sense, but it does. This is really Riley's area. She does a lot in here.
When's the last time you cooked
really
a meal?
We don't hang out in this area very much, me and Caleb.
When's the last time you cooked something? Yeah, that is y'all's side.
I guess this is where all the magic happens.
Really?
That's what they say in cribs. That's what they say. That's like every episode. They're like, well, this is where the magic happens.
Okay.
yeah, that's where I sleep. This is the bathroom. My bathtub. That's one thing when we were picking out a house, I wanted the bathtub. It's all dirty because it looks like Zeppelin got in it. He likes to get in the bathtub. I think it must be cool. There's our shower. It's pretty cool. Zeppelin also likes to sleep in the shower because it's cool.
Shower, it's cool.
It's got a big shower head. It's pretty cool. It's nice. Bathroom. That's the bathroom. This is our closet.
Our closet is a bomb.
Well, this is what happens when you come back from Oklahoma. You come back from California, you come back to Oklahoma.
Back and forth. All of my clothes are in California. I only have some here.
So pretty much, this is pretty much all my clothes. Your clothes are just here and here. I mean, here's our closet. We have Grinch and reindeer costumes up there from Christmas, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's the closet. This from here over is music tees, band tees, AC/DC, Metallica, Rolling Stones. This is Offspring, Metallica, another Metallica. That's all band tees. Out into the garage. Usually I park my truck out here, but it's not out here because we're about to leave. This is where I thought I would put a lot of my trophies. It looked good when I had everything set up. Then once some of the stuff started to fall off the wall, it kind of is whatever.
We need to put some shelves in here.
A bunch of stuff from whenever I was amateur. Monster cups and helmets that I had from when I was amateur. And I got into Fox and I got sponsored by Monster. This is the Bronze Boot Award from, I believe, Minio's. 2012.
You have some Loretta stocks in the office.
This is really all you care about from Loretta. This is these national championship wins. So that's about all you care about. Monster Cup, Super Mini All Stars. I won more, but my Minio. Another Minio's, the Silver Tire, Dunlop Silver Tire. This is the best guy in the big bike class, I'm guessing. It's more jerseys from all my numbers. They were up here, but they fell. And then all my over here is the really cool stuff. Behind our bench and our tubes for the lake and our my scooters. But behind that and behind all the wood that Riley was gonna build a table with and never did, just like I said she was going to. There's a bunch of wood back here.
I thought I could build
some stuff.
I felt creative.
All my Supercross win trophies. Not all of my podiums, but all of the ones I've won. So here's all of those. My Amateur of the Year award in 2015? Amateur Motocross Rider of the Year, I think. Yeah, that's what that is.
Okay.
And all my pro stuff, basically.
Nice.
This is my gun safe. Just a quickie. Guns. I don't have
it's,
a lot
it's
in
too
there
dark,
right now.
You can't even see.
Some are getting fixed and some are worked on and built. Here's where usually my gear is all stacked up and everything neat and nice, but Riley's been dropping the ball on that as well.
Well, maybe if you were riding, I'd be more focused on it.
I'm just kidding. And then this is my last gun room. This is my last gun room. But
this is our first home.
This is our first house that we got and we decorated. And
we?
This is Zeppelin. This is Zeppelin. I think you guys met him earlier, but this is what we call Zeppelin. He is, look at his face. He's a raccoon. But he's well-trained. Give me your paw. Oh, good, nice to meet you too. Other paw, good job. He's stupid though. Come on.
No, he's not.
Come on. Come on. Good boy. Good
boy. Alrighty. Now good we're heading boy. To the airport, boy. So yeah. I will...
And we gotta leave Zep.
We gotta leave Zep.
With Caleb. Heading hey, to the airport.
You know you're supposed to film me while I'm talking, right?
I'm not gas. I'm doing my best.
I think everybody in this video is gonna know that you're not gas.
I think you'll be proud of me though.
Gas is gonna edit it, but you know.
Oh shit, I made you blurry.
Yeah, we're gonna go to the airport now. I gotta head out. Getting surgery tomorrow at noon, I believe, is what the doctor said.
Yeah.
He said it was noon. And then hopefully,
You wanna show your shoulder really quick? Yeah. Now you can see. So we're getting that fixed up.
It's got a big, it's pretty. Definitely popping. If you've seen my Instagram, you saw it for the past couple days. It's basically the plates trying to come through. It looked good. I had like three or four trusted doctors that I trusted look at it. And even the night I got the x-ray after the race in the ER, they were like, yeah, it's definitely broke. It's broke next to your plate and it kind of goes into the screws too. But they were like, it should heal fine. It wasn't displaced a whole lot and it wasn't too bad. Whenever I came back here on Saturday, because I was like, something just, like, this bump, like, I know my body and this bump, it's sticking up a lot. I was like, this doesn't look like the original x-ray. It doesn't feel like and look like visually the original x-ray. Got it done. The plates, it's sticking up. It's coming off the skin. Or it's coming
trying
off,
to poke
it's
through.
Off the bone. Yeah, it's poking bad. Like, I feel like I'm getting cuts. So, yeah.
We're going to go put a Band-Aid on it and then try St. Louis?
That's the plan. Hopefully try to come back by St. Louis. That's what I planned on. Literally, that's what we planned on. Tried to think of as soon as we were leaving to go to the hospital from Dallas was when I could come back. And this doctor that I'm going up to see.
Ting.
Yeah. Dr. Ting up in San Jose or San Francisco or wherever he is.
San Francisco.
He's good. So I trust him. So hopefully we can get it done. It's simple surgery. It's just plate of collarbone. It's not like they're doing anything crazy. They got to take the old plate back or take the old plate off it. And just put a bigger one on top.
All right.
So, yeah, nothing crazy. But, yeah, we got to go to the airport. So
and we'll bring you all to San Fran.
Oh, you all can come and witness me coming off of coming out of surgery. Wow, it's going to be so fun.
Hey, babe.
I know that you're waiting for me like a dog, but have some patience for the part of me that's lost. There's been 100 times when I don't recognize any of you that love me. I try to memorize and identify, but it's all getting foggy.
We're going to get fixed.
What?
We're going to fix you.
Yeah, going to get fixed.
And then this crazy wants to fly out right after.
Yeah. Yeah, I want to get back to Oklahoma ASAP.
Okay.
So we're going to see. Hopefully my surgery's done in time for us to make it on the flight. Or I guess just me. Riley's going back to California to do a photo shoot.
One of us got to work.
Yeah. So, I'm solo, but that's all I need help with, really, is getting on the first flight.
I'm going to help you on the plane.
But if I make the first flight, I'll be fine. All right. I'll go to sleep on the flight and then wake up and I'll be off the stuff. But I remember one time we went straight from the surgery to the airport and I was not right for like a little bit.
Nope.
Like until the first flight landed, I was gone.
Which one was that?
Like first.
Houston? Houston. Yeah. I remember that one.
Okay. We got to go.
Bye. We're at the surgery center. I'm probably going to get yelled at for this, too.
Probably going to get yelled at for filming. Yeah.
But we're in San Fran, so I'm not even allowed to go back. But I'll see you after.
Yeah, so she's going to wait in the lobby. I think they're going to let her. I don't even think they're supposed to let her.
If not, I'll go to the mall.
We told her that, we told her that, that we already checked out our hotel and we're going straight to the airport. So hopefully they'll let her stay. That's what they did last time, I think. Ting's pretty cool, so it's been... There's some ligaments or some tendons or something catch on the plate and stuff, so the plate's about to come through my skin, so needs it. So,
hopefully I get to see you after that.
Yeah, this is the longest I've ever had to wait for surgery. Usually I just go in, the next night or the next day or that night.
What's it been, 10 days?
Well, yeah, but it was kind of unplanned. We didn't
it looked all good at first. It was all lined up, and I don't know what happened, but the blade started to move, started to come out, and now it's basically trying to come out through the skin, so it sucks. But it's really more disappointed that we lost, like, a few days. More disappointed that we lost a few days, and I could have gotten it a week ago, and we could have been a week ahead of schedule, but there was no way for us to know. So.
Let me see, I need to focus on you. Hold on.
So yeah, I'll probably go back for surgery here in like, I don't know, probably hopefully they call me back in like 30 minutes to go start prepping, put on my gown, get juiced up.
Bye, I love you. Do good. Well, update for the vlog, we're not flying out tonight. Austin took too long in surgery.
I took too long, yeah. So, for sure.
So I canceled our flights and got us new ones at 6 a.m. So we're going to a hotel near the airport. But I thought we should do this anyways, because I don't think you should fly right after. So it's okay.
First flight, I'm still coming off. I'm so tired and hungry.
Okay, we'll order you food. So tired.
I'm gonna go back to sleep.
Okay, night night. Drink till I'm sideways.